Umpire Lee Barron from England blows the free hit. Partier will take their time. For Melander. Melander will drop it back. Valenciennes will bring the ball forward now. Just try and work a gap. Save from Oscar Moberg. Again, Oscar Moberg managed to keep the ball away from the Partil goal. And Hemvik will once again set the ball up. Talks to his players, sets them up. Melander. Back to Hemvik. Play revolving through Hemvik at the moment. Early chance there. It was Hellstrand who had the shot. But Lefebvre was up to it in the Valenciennes goal. Again. Looks left, then goes to Melander again. Good ball around the back. But lifted up there off Melander's stick. It's Dahin who can move the ball wide to Gezi. Little Gezi looks into the D, nothing's on. Strobe gets in strong there. And we have our first goal of the game. Van Hecke. Camille Van Hecke scores for Valenciennes. So it's Valenciennes 1, Partil 0. Trying to fire it in there for Melander just to deflect into the goal past Lefebvre. But the ball flying up instead, and so a foul adjudged. Umpire Sergei Supron from Ukraine. Franks gets into the top of the D. Again, it's ball's come up at Van Hecke, scorer of the goal. Hemvik just controls the ball, allows mass substitution. Partil opting to play with five outfield players at the moment. But Lundqvist steps off, which allows Franzen to come back on. Sorry, Mobo to come back on. Franks. Passes the ball through Helston. Luke Joe's Darkin, failing to trap the ball in. Working the ball out. Good use of the balls before there by Darkin. Darkin now gets the ball high up the court where Franks was trying to get the shot in. Again. It's now Lundqvist that has taken the place of Hemvik in their middle on that pivot position. He waves Melander forward. Forward, he says. He wants targets. He fires it in. It's hit a foot, and we're going to have a penalty corner. Umpire Suffren from the Ukraine. Points with two hands. Partil will have a chance here. Axel Strobe goes across, places the ball on the injection mark. It's in there just waiting. Here it comes, Lundqvist, Hemvik. Hemvik hits the post. Hemvik hits the post, and it's Lefebvre, who managed to sweep the ball away. Partil coming so close to getting the equaliser. And we're halfway through this first half of this first Pool C game. Pool C, a round robin featuring the four teams that finished in the bottom two places of Pool A and Pool B. But remember, they carry forward the result against the team they played in the pool and finished in the bottom two with. As Valenciennes come forward, but Partil able to shepherd that out. Lundqvist doing a great job, and now the ball's right down the other end. And a goal! It's all level here. Partil a level. And Carl Hemvik, who has played for the majority of the first quarter of this game, at the back, with all the play going through him, gets forward and gets his side back in this, having seen the ball ricochet back off the post just a minute beforehand. And so it's Hockey Club Valenciennes 1 and Partil Sport Club 1. But great chance here. But Franks kicks the ball. I think he unexpectedly received that on this near side. And now Partil can come again. There's a chance for a goal, and it was Hellstrand who had the shot. But great keeping there by Lefebvre, who raced onto the pitch, and he's managed to dislodge the goal from its position. And he's literally raced on, made the save, and now he's going to make his way off the pitch as Suffren. Umpire Suffren gets the goal back into position there. Hey, strengths firing the ball in there. And now Lundqvist comes forward. Little slip. And Gezi was looking to get forward. Grindqvist. Valencien. Some nice stick work there, but it's come to nothing. And now Hellstrand can break. Hellstrand on the left-hand side. He'll look for help. Lundqvist is there. The tall figure of Lundqvist. Looks for Strobe. Erik Strobe, the captain. Lundqvist will set himself up in the middle. There's Henvik. Strobe thought about spinning. Lundqvist, back to Henvik. Those two happy to play the ball around. And then Henvik fires it in. Probably looking for the stick of Hellstrand to try and deflect it past Lefebvre. Could be interesting as Melander chases it down. Melander rushing back to get into the tight formation. Partilla employing, try and keep out Valencien. Partil just happy for the ball to go down the other end. They got themselves back into this game. Great little ball by Franks down the line. And now Gezi nearly getting the ball in from the tight angle. But Carl Oscar Moberg, more than a match for that. He got his near post covered. Nothing was going to sneak in there. Henvik. Back to Lundqvist. Henvik, the scorer of Partil's goal. Van Hecke, the scorer of Valenciennes' goal. And we have a second goal. A second goal for Partil. They were behind, but they've come back. They now find themselves 2-1 up. Just over 4 minutes remaining, and this game's still too tight to call. And we're going to have a penalty corner. So Valencien number 10, Damien Franks, will stand over the ball. Oh. Early move means play has to go to the halfway line. And that's the captain, Luc-Jose Darchin, who fires the ball in to Moberg. Moberg's call up on here, and he left a gap in the near post. The ball's bounced back off the boards, and we're going to have another penalty corner. A very strange bend on the ball there, which sort of kept it in. So we're into the last 3 minutes of this first half of this first Pool C game. This time Darkin's going to inject it himself. Goes to the top. It's through the legs. Trying to find Thomas Hodd. The feint of deflections takes the ball away from danger. And Partil survive. So Henvik playing out on that left, was playing the central role, looking for Melander, but it doesn't find Melander, and instead the ball is fired into the goal. By number 16, Magnus Madsen. And Partil, having been a goal down, now find themselves in the much stronger position of being 3-1 up. But then earlier today, the host club, East Grinstead, were 3-1 up and managed to give that lead away and found themselves 4-3 down at the break and eventually lost 6-5. And oh, it's crept in! The feintest of touches from Van Hecker. And Van Hecker, scorer of his side's first goal, gets his side's second goal. And Valenciennes are straight back in this one. They've reduced Partil's two-goal lead back down to one. We've still got a minute to play here. Ball just fired down the middle of the court there. Van Hecker was alert to it. A little stick. Feint of touches, just managed to guide it past Karl-Oskar Moberg in the Partil goal. Looks like Melander's come to be the deep player. Lundqvist has gone right, Henvik on the left. Off the boards, try and whip it across the face of the goal. Valenciennes come forward. They didn't take the free hit from the right place. And that, ladies and gentlemen, will be the last action of this first half of this first Pool C game at the Crawley Volkswagen Euro Hockey Indoor Club Champions Cup for men here in East Grinstead at the K2 Leisure Centre at Crawley. We take a break with Hockey Club Valenciennes 2, Partil Sport Club 3. Thank you. So just moments away from the resumption of this game, the second half of this first game in Pool C. Pool C for the teams that finished in the bottom two positions, the third and fourth places in Pool A and Pool B, that were played on Friday and Saturday morning. Those four teams go into Pool C, and now they're fighting for the right to stay in the top division of European indoor club hockey. The Toronto secure a place for their nation's association, send a representative to next year's tournament. So whereas it may not be these teams that will be here next year. And that's a great chance, and a great chance leads to a great goal by Magnus Mattsson. Suddenly he was open and he launched himself at the ball. And Partille extend their lead once more. 4-2 leaders at the moment. A goal that really came from nothing. Fantastic strength. Launching himself through the ball and deflecting it past Lefebvre. And Partille can come again, but there's been a slip. Hellstrand slipping over there. Hellstrand to Lundqvist. We'll find Henvik on the far side. Henvik gone to play on the right now. Started out in the middle of the back three, then went to the left in the first half, but now he finds himself on the right. Valencien. Four outfield players and a goalkeeper. Tight formation. It's a little bit wider on their left. The Partille right, making sure that play can't go down the right-hand side. Mattsson just plays it back out there, the goal scorer. Well, the goal scorer for the fourth goal. Henvik to Melander. Melander to Lundqvist. Lundqvist, tall, stocky man. Great strength. Fires it to Mattsson, who tries to find Henvik down the right-hand side. But Valencien captain Dahan can nudge the ball forward. Comes to the halfway line, almost ceremoniously stops the ball there as he enters into the Partille half. Lundqvist calmly walks the ball to the top of the D. Making sure all his players in the right place. Captain Erik Strobe. It's back on, right in the centre of the court. And come to Henvik. Henvik tries to deflect it past Lefebvre. Henvik again, he's caught into the corner. Lundqvist will fire it in. But it missed everybody, including Hellstrand, who was in there. Hellstrand's already got one goal in this. Six Maxine Dahin to number eight. Luke Joe's Dahin, the captain. There's his brother, Maxime. Moves it wide to Van Hecker. Moberg will once again move off the pitch. That's Henvik to step on. Henvik looks around, just checks the time. Erik Strobe. To Melander, Lundqvist back to Melander. Melander looks up and finds Axel Strobe. Moving across, there is Axel Strobe, that's who he's after. Henvik ran off, he shouldn't have ran off. It was Strobe going off to allow Moberg to come back on. Partille nearly found themselves down to just four players there. skipper, Eric Strobing. He's got the ball, looks forward, nothing on. Plays the safe option back to Lundqvist, who looks down the line, but nothing's on there, and the ball will pass back to Valenciennes. And we've got 15 minutes left in this first Pool C encounter. Mahin. Oh, Mahin's hit the post. Oh, both teams have hit the post in this match. Good save from Moberg there. Number 8, Luke Joes Dahin, the captain of Valenciennes. Got the shot in. It wasn't a particularly hard shot, but still, Moberg had to be alert, got himself down. He'll deflect the ball away. Portillo certainly worked hard. After going a goal down, they've worked hard to get themselves right back in this game and then take the lead. And scorer of the fourth goal, Mattsson, there was the target for Lundqvist, but he just couldn't quite control it. He was rather outstretched. The ball runs off the back line and Valenciennes will start again. And this is Grindzinski. Grindzinski, his headband on, his mane of hair. Moberg doing his job there, keeping out the reverse flick from Thomas Hott. Grindzinski cuts this one out and now he drives forward for Valenciennes, trying to get them back in the game, but now he's lost it. Mattsson has the ball, drives down the right, comes inside. He's got the keeper to beat. He tries to get the ball over Lefebvre, but Lefebvre manages to stand his ground. And now Valenciennes come forward. The game's opened out slightly here as Thomas Hott tries to get the shot in, but the ball goes over the back line. And suddenly a rush of end-to-end action comes to an end there, and Lundqvist can calm everything down. And gets his players set. Melander looked back and then was able to jink in forward. That's Axel Melander. Simon Melander and the team as well. Lundqvist looks for Hemvik. Those two have worked really, really hard at the back there. Hemvik gets robbed. There's a chance here, but in the end, Lundqvist did his job as a defender and managed to keep the ball out, despite Leonard Frossisard's attempts to get the ball in there. But now, Valenciennes come forward again. Mahin, oh! And yet again, Frossisard. Leonard Frossisard, who was trying to get the ball inside the near post. As we have a whistle. Lee Barron from England calls for the pitch to be stamped down. So ongoing repairs to the pitch here at the K2 Crawley. Specialised indoor pitch used for the national championships held at Wembley, taken around various locations here in England for big indoor tournaments. It's been up to Sheffield, into Corby, now it finds itself here in Crawley. Grindzinski can run at Lundqvist, goes wide right, whips the ball across, and Moberg runs on from the bench to make sure the ball can't get in there. I think Grindzinski's shot actually was going wide anyway. But that's one of the dynamic effects of these new rules, that goalkeepers can just come on and off at will. And sometimes you get these flying saves. those people who watch the English National Championships, the Maxi Nutrition Hockey Fives at Wembley would have seen Philip Neuser fly full length across to keep Canterbury at bay. Now Henvik. Henvik's taken up the middle slot there. Finds Lundqvist right down the boards on the right hand side. Van Hecke, scorer of Valenciennes' first goal, gets this attack going. Drzinski to Dahin. Dahin, the Valenciennes captain. Ball in there was intended for Van Hecke to try and deflect past Moberg. And we're into the last quarter of this game. Only 10 minutes to go. And Partille are leading this one 4-2, and they'll be very grateful for their first win of the tournament and their first 5 points. And their quest to stay up, to keep a place for Swedish indoor hockey in this tournament. It's a good ball, finds Melander. Melander drops it back to Axel Melander. So Strobe back to Melander. Now this is Strobe again, the captain, Erik Strobe. Back to Henvik. Henvik's got three options forward now. Partille opting to play with two at the back. Strobe comes deep to meet it. They're back with three at the back now. Henvik playing on the right. Finds Lundqvist in the middle. Lefebvre makes the save. Now Dahin, the captain. Luke Joseph Dahin drives left. He's got three Partille defenders around him, but somehow he manages to break clear. Now can he set something up? He can indeed. But Lebrun couldn't make the most of it. And in the end, his deflection rolled tamely wide. Strobe. Henvik into Mattsson. Mattsson scored the fourth goal. And you can't keep that on the deck. And we've got a timeout called by Partille. With just a little over 8 minutes left here in Crawley. Of course, if you missed any of the action from Crawley, from this Crawley Volkswagen Euro Hockey Indoor Club Champions Cup, then you can watch full match reruns available on East Grinstead's YouTube channel. You can relive every second of this tournament, the highs, the lows. Of course, some great games still to come up this evening. At 16:40 British time, we've got Kolos Sekvita Finistra versus East Grinstead. And then the first semi-final is at 10:06 local time, Complutense versus Dynamo Yekaterinburg. And then at 7:15 local time, Harvestuda versus Royal Racing Club to Brussels. For these two teams, this is their last game today. They'll come back for a final game tomorrow. French player there, Sylvain Elghezi. Penalised for spitting into his opponent. Mattsson lays it off to Melander. Melander fires Henvik. Henvik's gone back to that middle position, though they've now split. They've gone left and right at the back there. Lundqvist has stepped up the right-hand side. There's Mattsson picking the ball up from the middle and just playing it out to Melander. Melander and Henvik playing quite deep at the moment. Well, they're in the lead. They don't necessarily need to force the issue at the moment. They just need to keep the ball away from Valenciennes. Froissan closing in, pressing hard. Allows some space behind. They can find Mattsson, but Mattsson drops it back. Melander's gone really deep. Lundqvist leaves it. Ball finds Mattsson, but Mattsson can't control it, and the ball bobbles up, and that, ladies and gentlemen, will be Valenciennes ball. And here comes Grzinski. Dahin deflects towards the goal. It wouldn't have been a goal though, because he was outside the D there. Dahin again. Well, the Ukrainian umpire, Sergei Suprin, has decided that he has spun that ball in. Hits the foot. Hemvik, great ball forward to Hellstrand. But Hellstrand's lost it. And we're going to have a penalty corner. And I wouldn't be surprised if... Yeah, his hand's in his pocket at the moment. What colour is he going to bring out? I think it's going to be green. Eric Strawberry protesting his innocence. I would imagine he's saying, look, he did it to me. Anyway, it's a yellow. I think we saw a signal of three there. So, Portillo, they find themselves 4-2 up. They've got best part of 6 minutes to play. But they're down to four players and they've got to defend this penalty corner. Good crowd in this evening. Valenciennes have a penalty corner in front of their own fans. El Ghezzi fires it hard, but Carl Oscar Moberg in the Partil goal is able just to charge that down. Although it goes up in the air, he's making a save, so he's quite legitimately allowed to do that. Ball goes off the sideboard, so it's going to be a hit in, and Dahin fires it across. And it looks like Carl Hemvik is hurt, and Carl Hemvik has had an absolutely fantastic game. There's some concern down there. Looks like he's all right. Gets an encouraging pat from the support staff, and Hemvik will stride away. And there's a wave down to the other end where Maxim Dahin waves back apologetically. So with all the discussion over now, we can now start. Lundqvist, whistle goes, and now they can make the substitution. Lee Barron's not happy. And it would appear that Lee Barron has got a problem with how the substitution was made. So we have the situation here. We have a situation here where Partil will be defending this penalty corner. Not with five players, not with four players, but with just three players. Moberg, Mattsson, and it looks like Lundqvist is back there. Now, if ever there was a time that Valencian would fancy their chance of scoring, it would be now. And they do. And it's Maxine Dahin who finishes off the move, and Van Hecker wants the game to get going, but of course the team's under suspension, but the longer they take getting reset, the more seconds tick down. Erik Strobri loses the ball. Partil are back to full strength, it looks. And Hellstrand has the chance there. Now, Dahin comes forward, the captain. Strobri's taken that from the wrong place. Yes, I'm right. Partil are back to full strength. They have five. They have Mattsson, Strobri, Hellstrand, Lundqvist, and Hemvik on. And Hemvik's quite allowed to be on this time. Great touch by Mattsson. Mattsson controls it, takes it out wide right. Gets the hit, drives. His shot gets charged down. Hellstrand tries to put it back in, but it goes into the corner, safely off under the curtains. Just under 4 minutes remaining. Valenciennes find themselves one goal behind. A draw isn't really any good for either of these sides. It would just give them 2 points. Valenciennes are only one goal down at the moment, and there is a single point available for a loss with a goal difference of no more than two. But even that's not going to really be helpful. As Grudzinski comes forward. Under 3 minutes left now. Grudzinski looks to his right. He finds his captain, Luc Jooz. Dahin again. Back to Grudzinski. Grudzinski just changes the angle slightly. Dahin's in there. Van Hecker tries, and there's a follow-up there. We have an equaliser here in Crawley. Suleiman Elghezzi pulls it level. And Valenciennes, who scored the first goal of this encounter but have been behind ever since, find themselves all square with just over 2 minutes to go here at the K2. And now Valenciennes will be thinking they could sneak this one and claim their first 5 points. It's fired in at pace. And Valenciennes are desperate to get this match going again. Grudzinski brings the ball up slowly. He doesn't want to waste this. He's going to pick his pass. Well, the sort of draw really doesn't help either of these sides. They'll get 2 points. But they'll only have one game left. Dahin fires it across goal. And Moberg will exit the court again. Hemvik, who's been fantastic at the back today and also scored a goal for his side. To Lundqvist, who's equally been fantastic. Van Hecker was pressing high there. Hellstrand's down the right-hand side. Tries to force the ball in. Dahin's there. Grudzinski's there. Now Dahin will drive out. But Lundqvist picks it up. He's got Mattsson, and Mattsson will score! And Mattsson puts Partil back in the lead. It's Valenciennes 4, Partil 5. And we're into the last minute. We're into the last 40 seconds. Dahin comes down the right-hand side. He's looking to try and get an equaliser. But Partil had the ball back. Strobri, the captain, is holding him off. And the ball is right up against the sideboards there. Really, it can't go anywhere. We're into 20 seconds. Valenciennes call for the bully. They get it. Van Hecker's not happy. The clock's still ticking. There's only 10 seconds left. And Mattsson races clear. He's got Grzinski. Grzinski to beat. But the Hooter's going to go. And Partil will register their first victory of this Crawley Volkswagen Euro Hockey Indoor Club Championships Cup for men here in East Grinstead at the Crawley K2. And so Valenciennes will find themselves on the bottom of the table. And really, without much chance of pulling clear, they'll play East Grinstead tomorrow. Which, of course, you can see that live on this live stream on East Grinstead's YouTube channel. Still to come, make sure you join us at 4:40 local time here in England for Kolos Sekvia Venistra versus East Grinstead. And later on, we've got both semi-finals live, 10-6, Complutense versus Dynamo, and the second one at 7:15, Harvestuda versus Royal Racing Club de Brussel. But for now, it's goodbye from Crawley.